While Clint Eastwood favored anti-heroes in front of the camera, behind the camera, he's gone full hero with tremendous success, especially heroes ripped from the headlines, as has been the case with the last two films he's directed. And they have been particularly successful. Although with the last one, Sully, while it was an enjoyable film, and there's no doubt that Clint Eastwood is a very talented filmmaker, and can take whatever curveball is thrown at him, and he's thrown himself a curveball with this movie here that we're about to watch the trailer for, and we'll talk about that in a moment. But I just didn't think there was enough story for Sully to warrant a feature film, and I have some concern that could be the case here as well. But the curveball that Clint Eastwood has thrown himself here, and he would call it a hook to get people interested in the movie, is that this is the story of the three Americans on a train in Paris who stopped a terrorist attack. And in this movie, those three gentlemen play themselves. Oh, the plot thickens. Let's see how they are. I mean, they don't have to be the best of actors. They just have to be competent actors. And Clint Eastwood, who's also a producer here, there are ways that you can cover for that. You can prop up a mediocre actor easily with tricks from behind the camera. And you can insert whatever shade you'd like here down below in the comments at whatever actor you dislike and feels is propped up by others. Okay, so let's take a look. I love the title. I think the 1517 to Paris, which was the name of the autobiography of the same story, has a lot of energy and excitement to it. It could be a Liam Neeson movie, but it could also be a Hitchcock movie. And so let's see what we've got here. Although either one would be obviously fabulous for this film. Let's see what these guys got. And Clint. Good old Warner Brothers. They love them over there. I've traveled by train through Paris, through France. It's fabulous.
Snacks coming in at 12 o'clock.
Gentlemen. There you go.
Thank you. Look at the baby soda, Spencer. Alex, shut the heck up.
I've done that too. They're very charismatic. You clever bastard! It's gonna be a huge hit!
Dream, at some point in time, a transition takes place. You learn how to leap higher. You start challenging yourself to dig deeper. Something in you that you never activate is lying dormant in there. Don't try and take any shortcuts. Do what you know is right. We've been chosen for this great work.
I don't know, man. You ever just feel like life is just pushing us towards something? Like some greater purpose?
I have to feel for that actor who has to play the terrorist boy. He's like, I can't believe this is the only role that I can get. I loved it until the very, very end. I don't, everybody has their own beliefs, but I think that when you start saying, like, I was on that train for a reason, you know, my whole life has been building to me being on that train, I don't know, I think that starts to get a little bit too one demographic-y, right? But I think that everyone could get behind the overall message of this trailer, which I thought was incredibly uplifting, that you can be your own hero, you know, that you can rise to the occasion, in any occasion, right? I think that's a wonderful message. And I thought that the way this was put together, it wasn't so much about what these men did, but who they are. I think that's great. But that, I guess that's my personal, where I come from personally, my orientation, the power comes. Some people like to believe that they're being manipulated by a greater force and, pieces moved around on a board. I'm a very strong believer in the individual and the power of the self. So I guess that, you know, that's what appeals to me about this trailer. But if it can seem like it has a broad enough appeal, and if it can hit the heartland of America, which obviously is where it's aiming, and, you know, I think they would like the fate angle argument. I think a number of people would. The same people who came out to see American Sniper in droves, huge hit for Clint Eastwood. I think they would come to see this as well. This is like, you know, there's a thing going on where the Hollywood studios get groups to book group tickets to come and see movies to make it an event. It's worked very well for religious films, and it worked quite well for The Wonder, for Wonder most recently. And I can see this being a big group sales event for many institutions. If I were Warner Brothers, I'd be running around to churches, schools, colleges, the military. I'd be like, you all have to go, and you have to go as a group, opening weekend. And they'd be like, I think that we do. And everybody wins, right? So I like this quite a bit. I like this going through time and showing these men's lives. I think that's great. I hope that Clint Eastwood can balance them out very well. They're extremely charismatic, but I think from a little bit, also, I think that's what also hurt the end of the trailer a little bit. I don't think they're particularly good actors, and I think it's quite obvious. I don't think they can handle serious dialogue. Serious dialogue is the hardest to do. The mini can of Coke thing was great, though. It was great. And what American hasn't done that? Oh, it's so funny. All right. So what did you think of the trailer? Write your thoughts down below. And also, what camp are you in, if you feel like sharing? Are you in the power of the individual? You know, we make our own fate. Or are you very much a believer in a greater power and fate, you know, being fate acting on you? All right. So write your thoughts down below. You can check out some more videos right now.